After a 2 week long break, because last episode was a recap episode, so we're back into episode 22. It's going to be very exciting, very controversial. Very exciting though. Are we going to be getting the captains versus, or the Soul Reapers versus the Quinces? The extended fight that I really always wanted. Are they going to be able to handle that okay, and how are they going to do it? Of course, we're going to have a Giselle-centric episode, so are they going to do that scene justice? And surely, Yoda Witches should be appearing within this episode too. So big excitement overall on all of this. I wonder how they're going to be ending off the episode. My guess is probably Toshiro towards the end. And are we going to have our boob scene with Orihime? Who knows? Let's find out. Let's get into it, because you know I get excited about watching these and I want to get right into it. So let's get into it, shall we? And of course, hit that like and subscribe. All right, fixing up from last episode. Is that a new soundtrack? Sounds like a new soundtrack. Okay. Some great effects going on so far. Oh, damn. Okay. That's some really cool destructive animation, I guess we should say. Ranger just getting bodied with a boulder. And then now coming on with the barriers. Come on. He blasts off with Sun Tenkeshin and all. So, Orihime with the saves. But I always find it funny how it rains in Soul Society, because, like, there's technically a barrier that doesn't let anyone in except for, like, Soul Reapers. So, to let rain in the barrier is always just a funny concept to me. I've been thinking the same thing since this battle started. If this is a battle between Soul Reapers and Quinces, then that means Ishida and I. Ah, okay. So, he said it without saying it. Yeah. Oh, no! I love this OST! Oh, it's one of my favourites. Banging OST. I don't know what he thinks about it, though. That means we know what we have to do. What, save Ryu? Yeah, because that's how the gang is, man. I won't forgive him for leaving us without answering, but I'll chase after him and force him to at least tell me why. That's my goat. Oh, kick his art. They did the manga panel. I like that. See, not like Naruto, where he's like, I'll just talk to him. I'll talk him back. Nah, Ichigo's like, I'm going to kick his ass and bring him back. Hey, big Kisuke is back. Let's go. Okay. I think it's a very good way to start off the episode, giving a little bit of reflection, but also showing how mature Ichigo has become. He's not really thinking emotionally about it. He's more so thinking of, like, the situation and understanding that Uryu isn't going to make a choice, you know, a choice based on nothing. Like, he knows that Uryu's thought about it, and there's a reason. He just wants to know that reason, which I do think Ichigo's come a long way about when it comes to thinking about rationality. Nah, fam. What are you going to do? Still in Volstandig? I thought it was tiring for you, Candace. 3v1 on Byakuya? This is new, right? This is extended, right? Dun, 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 dun. Oh, again, music choice, great. Eva, is that Eva? Eva and Komamura. Hello? Oh, this is... Oh, that's sad. Don't tell me the fight got disrupted because of that explosion. I mean, obviously it did, but... Basby? Oh, jeez, Renji! Damn! Okay. They did the banter between Renji and Basby. I thought you might have decent taste with those super classy eyebrows. Dude, you're such a... I love it. Burner Finger 4! Most powerfulest Burner Finger yet. Not Giselle. Well, we knew it was coming. We knew. An unharmed girl. Isn't that kind of lame? Aren't you guys meant to be reluctant to do that type of thing? That was definitely a provoke, Yana. Be careful. Provoking so much to slice them down, that means it's likely that the slice itself will work. For instance, perhaps it'd be dangerous if the blood spills on us, or something like that. Yeah, Giselle got caught out. Plain dumb. But I do think it would be a bad idea for you to slice me. See, you can't act, Giselle. And while we're at it, allow me to expose another one of your acts! You referred to yourself as an unarmed girl just now. But you're a man, aren't you? Ah, oh, okay. Wait, what's the reaction? But frankly, you stink of semen! She got caught out! He got caught out! He got caught out! Yes! It was an act! It was an act! It was an act! Not Bambi! Bambi! Not like this! I've been saying this for years! It's an act! Now, what the purpose of that act is another question that we can discuss when I do the Giselle video. But it's an act. It's not genuine.
The Shiva canon is quite unique, created by using the secret techniques passed down from their family. It's not that kind of thing you can copy very easily. I'm afraid this will fall apart after firing a single shot.
Damn, really? Even someone like Kisuke can't make a replica cannon.
We still don't have enough energy for a shot.
There she is! There's Bay. Sheesh, come on. I'm glad they added the distortion. I'm glad that that was, because they skipped that in like Core 1, so I'm glad that they elaborated on that. Oh wait, there was a distortion between Hachi and Lisa? I didn't even notice that. Why did I just notice that now? I have to go back and check that, because I generally can't remember. What did they do to you, Bambi? What did they do? Oh, Kido! We love some Kido! Let's go! Was that in the manga? Okay, Ikaku, do some bits. Damn. No! Leave her alone! Oh, that- No! Damn, Bambi! I know you're like a puppet, but still. Wood?
It's not like anything you do is going to kill her. Bambi-chan is dead already.
It just goes to show how fearsome Bambi was, man. Like, take away all the emotion, pure ability. Menace. Yes! Finally, Mayuri, come clutch. Get rid of this bum. Get rid.
That's a cool title card. I like that. It's just that. It's just this episode. It's just something else, man.
Oh, leave Bambi alone. Get off her, man.
I need it. No, don't say it. I need your what? Not like this. Not like this, Bambi. You're better than this. What do you need, girl? I can give it to you. Just tell me.
No! Giselle! Stop! Fam, this is why I hate Giselle. Forget all the other stuff. This is why I hate Giselle. Leave her alone, man. Oh, God, man. Ugh. Hate Giselle.
Why are they putting so much animation in Giselle's lips for, man?
Oh, I like this OST too. Hey, Nemu, come on! Hey, Nemu with the save!
About 3 seconds should do it.
There we go. Hey, this is some good effects. I like this.
Ha. It didn't explode. Nope.
But now they have.
Oh, poor Bambi.
Oh, you used... Bambi is a human shield? Come on. Stop ragging her like that, man. That's my job.
I hate this episode.
I hate this episode so much, man.
Okay, Giselle. Settle down. Oh, no. Here we go.
March of the Zombies.
That's pretty good CG.
Well, it was. Now it's drawn, though.
I guess it can't be helped. I might have to leave this fight too.
Dear on, cars. There we go. Look at the goats.
Except for Loopy. We don't fuck with Loopy.
You're a chicken, Charlotte. No. Oh, no. Bring back the banter.
Oh, I forgot. Toxic. Toxic.
This is funny. Creechi is like, she's a hidden baddie for me. Like a hidden. Like I only just recently saw the light with her.
It was worth the trouble of stealing your bodies from Xylophora's storeroom.
So there you go. You finally know what's in there if you were an anime only and you didn't know.
So you got your own zombies. Well, it's not exactly zombies, but sure.
Okay, okay, okay. Let's go, Dodoni. Okay, Karuchi, okay. I mean, bit of a PNG, but come on.
At least you put her arm back on. I mean, you caused this problem to happen, but... Appreciate the gesture. Not Mr. Shiny over there?
Indeed.
My instinct's telling me that you are the one I must battle. After all, there's such a close resemblance between us.
Damn! The dodgy is from Charlotte. Okay, I understand. I don't like it, but I understand. I did notice that, like, she's in Volstandig too, so that's kind of interesting that Giselle's still able to, like, use a puppet and have them use Volstandig. Oh, that's a nice Cero! That's, yeah, a lot better than what it looked like in the anime, like, in the old one. Okay. You're still calling it that long-ass name. Okay, cool. You two can come out now. Mr. Captain... Ah, Toshiro. This is a little bothersome. It is. Looks cold, though. I ain't gonna lie, looks cold. So, I assume that that's the ending. There's no post-credits, I believe. I do think, you know, as a manga reader, next episode is going to be really, really good, because obviously it's a Toshiro fight, and I hope they really encapsulate what Toshiro is capable of, like the potential of like why Toshiro is classed as a prodigy, because he hasn't got that emotion holding him back. So I really can't wait to see that, and of course Mayuri as well. This episode in general, it was more funny than it was like, it was just a funny, fun episode. Like, it wasn't excessive or, you know, it didn't go in hard on animation. It just looked standard, like above average, which was really nice. It moved the plot on really well, especially with like Ichigo and the rest of them and Kisuke, Yoruichi making the cut, talking about the distortions and then going right into the zombies. Again, I think what this episode does is just elaborate why I hate Giselle and elaborates also more that Giselle's kind of character is based on an act. Now, the thing for me, which I hope the anime does, is explain why Giselle is posing under an act, because it would really be nice to know what Giselle's goal is, like, as an indefinite rather than a presumption. I guess like Kubo is very subtle within his manga and his story. I think it's pretty simple to know what Giselle's kind of goal is, but to have that as like hard evidence would be really nice as well. But like, that's the fun with like Kubo's, his Bleach, is that you can interpret things many different ways. I was a little bit disappointed with the last episode being 21, because it did show when Candice was talking about whoever gets the head of Ichigo or whoever like captures Ichigo or whatever, right? They become like, they get whatever wish they desire. And in the manga, it showed Meninas, Latoto, and Giselle and what they wished for. And it was like, for Latoto, it was like an infinite or endless amount of sweets. For Meninas, off the top of my head, it looked like this classy mansion bedroom type thing. And then for Giselle, it was like blacked out. And it would be presumed that it was like, you can presume that it's either censored, like a censored imagination of what Giselle was thinking at that time. People will say, oh, like, there was nothing there, like, Giselle wasn't really thinking of anything, it was blank. But considering, like, Giselle's facial reaction and her eyes, like, looking up means that, like, when somebody looks up, like, if you're having a conversation with someone and you ask someone a question and they answer you while looking up, you know, it's because they're trying to think. Or they are thinking of something, and because of Giselle's facial reaction at that point, we can consider it as something lewd or something that cannot be shown because it was lewd or was explicit. Based on that and what Giselle wants, can kind of insinuate what Giselle's goal is. But it's been an act. I'm glad the anime really reinforced that it was an act. Like, we actually get a full face of, like, Giselle's, like, you've been caught out face. But this has also been said twice. Like, oh, Giselle's like, oh, you can't cut an innocent girl, right? Because, like, Giselle's playing the act, right? Obviously, Giselle wants them to be cut. And Yumichika's like, you are a bad actor, right? And while we're on the fact of bad actors, you're also a dude as well. So, like, not only did Giselle try and play off that they didn't want to get cut, and we can see that within this episode, but they also have got the you caught me face, you know, that okay, fuck it, I ain't gonna deny it, Bambi going after them. And I think it is, you know, Giselle's character is extremely easy to understand what Giselle is as a character, and it really is unfortunate that, you know, people have diminished Giselle's character as nothing more than just a trans character, which isn't the case at all. Giselle can be more deeply discussed, and to just brush Giselle off as just a gender fluid character is just, I think, really diminishes the character a lot and very unjust
But that's my overall thoughts on it. I think the episode was just a really, really fun episode, and there's not really much more to say than that. I didn't really notice any kind of production issues on this episode, but again, I can't wait to rewatch and really dig deeper into things and get my overall thoughts on. But that's my live reaction, and I hope you guys enjoyed it too. With that being said, I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day, being handsome, and as always, people, peace out.